Wow.
Oh, they're on. Hi, guys.
Hey.
This thing on.
Okay. I'm about to hit 20 years in the fashion industry, and I'm 30 years old. I'm not 20. Anyways, just in case you were wondering. And I think my breakthrough moment really truly was Sports Illustrated, because in the curvy world, people knew who I was, but it also proved that people wanted to see curvy women and make it a normal thing, and that they too could be on fashion magazines in bikinis, and your back fat and cellulite could be portrayed around the world.
I loved my body and I was curvier, and then as I lost it, people were still mean, and it was like, I think you should just...
People are tight too when I lose a little weight.
Yeah, and
there's owners. People feel that they have ownership over your body in society today. And I think that it's really ridiculous, because you don't. My body is mine. I work out because I want to stay healthy. And if I happen to gain 10 pounds or lose 10 pounds, it's none of your business.
Yeah, I know I'm skinny. I'm looking in the mirror. I'm trying to eat burgers and do squats. And I like want an ass too. Like,
I
get
say.
It. I got it. Thank you. Like,
every time I work with you, there's a taco or a burger truck nearby.
Thanks, Ash.
Yes. Being in the industry for so long, I have never seen diversity catch fire the way that it has now. It's impressive that now, because the dialogue has changed so much on social media, fashion has said, okay, well, let's take into account what everybody actually wants, because everybody who's giving the comments, who's giving the commentary, saying, I want to see myself, fashion designers and big publications are finally listening.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How old were you when you started?
So,
you
know, this I mean, is
besides
my thing.
Two.
When I was in high school, I was like, Mom, I want to my mom came from Holland to America, was signed by Aileen Ford when she was 16. So my mom experienced New York as a 16-year-old coming over here. But as a mom, she chose to keep me in high school until I was 18, wouldn't let me sign to IMG. So I came, like, I think spring break of my senior year, I came to New York for the first time just to meet agencies. And I always fought that, but when I look back on it, I would have never changed it for a second. Like, the experiences I got to have in high school, and, like, I mean, even thank God, like, Instagram had just started. I was posting, like, weird pictures of flowers with, like, ugly filters on them. But it's, like, there are times I felt like I wish I had known myself better or been more confident in myself at those times. And I think with age, I've really been able to step into that power, and I hope that girls understand that if they wait, it's only 2 years from 16 to 18.
Yeah.
And, like, it is so worth it.
Me now compared to me a year ago,
yeah.
And I'm so much, I found myself more, I feel more confident in myself, I feel just better with myself, so I kind of have the same situation where I got signed when I was 14 in LA, and when I was 17, I went to my mom being like, no, I want to go to New York, and I really want to do this, like, big, for real, do it big, whatever, and she was like, all right, like, let's go talk to someone. So we came here, we spoke to someone, and everyone around me was like, no, we're waiting until you're 18, and I think the same thing for me. Like, I got to live as much of a normal life as I could. I went to school and I had all my friends and I grew, and I think mentally and physically I was in such a better place when I was 18 to do this, and I feel the same way as you.
I started at 21, so I started a lot later than you guys, and I'm very grateful for that for a few reasons. I felt more validated in my identity that I had, so I could combat kind of the insidious nature of the industry at times. The judgment, the doubt, the insecurity. When you are your commodity, when how you look is your job, at 16, how are you impervious to what the buy factors?
A lot has changed. And I think that, you know, people are much more mindful of where you're changing. And if you're naked on set, that everything is very closed off and that you feel comfortable. I think also there still needs to be education around what the Me Too movement actually means. Because I've had people on set try to brush my hair and then say, oh, I don't want to Me Too you. Mm. And it's like, well, that's, first of all, so insensitive.
And secondly, awkward.
It's awkward, yes. Also, you don't know the person you're brushing their hair, what they've been through and their experiences, or when you say a disgusting comment like that. So if you don't really understand the Me Too movement, just go look it up. I mean, it's literally everywhere now. And I have to say, like, I am so glad that it happened, because men are becoming more sensitive, women are taking action and having these conversations, and the set has actually changed.
I am, you know, asked about how comfortable I feel when I'm wearing something. Do you feel good? No more in this last year have I ever been asked, do you feel good?
That never happened.
That never happened.
Ever. Yeah.
And even if it's
never
not
like,
even,
oh, you want water?
Yeah.
Oh, you want to change your room? Go make it yourself.
Yeah.
Not Vogue, but.
You know. No, but in general. Other
I think a huge thing that I thought about during this time was the importance of educating management companies about this. And I think kind of an unspoken thing was the pressure that managers put on models to
do whatever it takes.
Yeah, and it almost became like a thing like, oh, but if you're going to go see this photographer, like, yeah, but you just have to do whatever he says. And it is always okay to tell your manager what you're comfortable with, and that should be a person that is going to fight for you. That's how you're going to have a successful career, is someone that really has your back. In times where I didn't do that and I didn't stand up for myself, I always look back and said I could have stood up for myself better.
Something beautiful that came out of this whole thing was the empowerment that it's brought to women, and it's even made me feel more empowered. It's just something really kind of amazing to look up to, all the women that have come out and kind of shared their story. I think it's really, really powerful to look at.
So I've learned how to kind of trust my intuition and gut on set, and because in times when I have not, it has not worked out nicely for me, but you always learn. And so I think just trusting myself on set, and when you get to that place of confidence, I think the photographers really respond to you better.
Kind of what Gigi was saying, just speaking up and feeling like at the end of the day, like, yes, people are going to recognize the magazine and the photographer, but it's your face that's on it.
And it's your face on it forever, and that picture will haunt you on Twitter for
years. Yeah.
And remember when she did this? And I was like, remember when I was an intimidated 16-year-old? I was scared. No, I was 18.
It could come back to haunt you, but not everyone.
I'm curious what picture it is.
Oh, girl.
But not everyone knows the backstory, and not everyone knows that sometimes it's not our decision or it wasn't our decision.
Kind of just like being naked by myself a lot of time has helped.
That's awesome.
So much. Like actually, just like being comfortable in my body, so that whatever situation I'm thrown in, obviously to a certain level, I can feel up to the task and feel good and feel excited and feel in control.
It's like some people are like empowered and excited to be naked, and like, that is amazing. And I wish I was one of those people, and I am not one of those people. And like, I've accepted that about myself, and like, that's okay. And like, there are times where I feel like I'm excited about a photographer or creative situation where like, I will do this or will do that. But there's also times where I can be like, even though I'm so excited for everyone and feel so happy with their empowerment and being naked themselves, it's okay that I feel differently about that.
I mean, I don't really like shooting naked, to be fair. I just like being naked.
I thought you were gesturing to me.
Yeah, she loves shooting naked.
We're both like,
well, the only reason I ever shoot naked is because they can't find clothes that fit me. And up until recently, I mean, thank you to all the designers that are making clothes our size now.
Yes.
I think that, you know, I'll forever be a model. I mean, there's, you know, Cindy will always forever be a model, Crawford. But, you know, you have businesses outside of just having a pretty face. And that's what I intend on doing. And, like, world domination would be great.
I was just going to say, I think longevity and, like, having a career that can really make a stamp on something and last a lifetime and last beyond that is very important to me. But at the same time, I'm not going to lie to you, I almost can't wait for the day that I am a bit older and I have a family and I can settle down, and just being able to like have that behind me and have that almost like Cindy. She has this amazing life with her family and everything, and she lives in Malibu and they live this beautiful life. It's just I love that hopefully one day that could be like the picture of just something where I feel accomplished and I feel like I did everything I wanted to do, and I still have work and I still do those things because I am arguably a workaholic. I think if you're going to strive too hard to be relevant, that's when it becomes ingenuine, and that's when you feel like you're forcing something. I think that just being super authentic and genuine and really just living your life and doing what you love and finding your favorite job and all of that, then it becomes not, it's not work anymore, and it's just, you're just living this beautiful life.
Well, that's a good way to end. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.